We wanted, as a presidency, together with ECDPM, to open the debate, to get out of the box, and let people talk together, business people, private sector, civil society, members of EU member states, ACP countries, people, in order to discuss what they want out of this special relationship. And this has worked well, so we are very happy with the result, and especially because there is no formal result. The questions are open, new questions have arisen, but nobody is for the moment ready to close them. That's exactly what I wanted. The document is a basis for the discussions today. It will be also the basis, one of the basis documents for the follow-up within the European Union and also ACP countries, I hope so. It's one of the inputs. It's an important input because the document wants to see what is the value added of the different elements of the Cotonou Agreement. From my point of view, sometimes it's a little bit too negative. It has been said today. There are good and less good examples. I know that the logic is that there is no good and bad examples, but still, I think that you could have also added some more positive examples in the document. So for me, it's a little bit too negative, but for the purpose of today, it was perfect because it launched the discussion, it created reactions, and from that point of view, perfect. I came yesterday morning from New York, so I had been at the summit together with our leaders. I think we have not yet completely understood how different the approach of the Agenda 2030 will be. The universal approach is not only universal for countries, but also universal for all social and economic groups and for each one of the persons. So I think the inclusiveness and the universality is something that is very complicated to present and represent in our future policies, not only development policies, but all policies. And so from that point of view, I think we have to digest. Some countries have already began to implement these into their national strategies. We are just at the beginning of doing that in Luxembourg. I know Sweden is very much working on that. We have to make sure that we do not concentrate too much on ourselves. I mean, we have to do it nationally, regionally, and globally. And in that part of the global agenda of the Agenda 2030, we have to make sure that development is not forgotten.